Hello children, welcome to Narayana live classes. Today we are discussing about the assessment of chemical bonding. So here there are five questions and the first question, do atoms exist as a single atom or as a group of atoms? So yes, some atoms exist as a single atom and sometimes it exists as a group of atoms. So in previous classes we discussed the monoatomic, diatomic. So monoatomic nothing but single atom, exists as a single atom. So more than one atom means either it is a diatomic or triatomic, means nothing but group of atoms. And the second question, are the elements which exist as atoms? Yes. So in the previous question we discussed some atoms exist as single atom. So here examples, inert gases can exist as atoms. Examples, what are the examples of inert gases? He, helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon. So these are the examples of inert gases and these are exist, can exist as single atom. And the third question, why do some elements exist as molecules and some as atoms? Why do some elements exist as single atom? Because the stability, because they are having the 8 electrons in the outermost shell. In the valency shell, which are having the 8 electrons, they are stable. So that's why they exist as a single atom. Which are not having the 8 electrons, which are having the less than 8 electrons in the valency shell. So they exist as molecules. This is about the third question. And next, fourth question. Why do some elements and compounds react vigorously while others are inert? Here there are the two points, there are the two reasons. So the first reason, it is due to the number of electrons in their outermost shell. It depends upon the number of electrons in the outermost shell. And also one more reason, bond strength between the atoms in compound. So by these two reasons, some compounds and some elements, they react vigorously with other elements. And next one, what is octet rule? Explain with the suitable examples. So in the previous questions we discussed which atom is having the 8 electrons in the outermost shell, that atom is stable. Okay, so here what is the octet rule? It is the tendency of an atom to acquire 8 electrons in their outermost shell, means to acquire the 8 electrons in their outermost shell, either it will lose electron or gain electron or by sharing electron to get the octet configuration. This rule is called octet rule. Okay, for example we can take two examples. We can take one is sodium and another one chlorine. So sodium, what is the atomic number of sodium? 11. So how can you write electronic configuration? So you can write electronic configuration 2, 8, 1. So sodium electronic configuration 2, 8, 1. So it contains one valency electron. If it lose one valency electron, then it will form Na plus. See here, the outermost shell contains 8 electrons. So to get octet configuration, sodium loses one electron. And one more example, if you see here chlorine. So what is the atomic number of chlorine? 17. So how can you write electronic configuration? 2, 8, 7. To get the octet configuration, how many electrons it requires? One electron it requires. So it will gain one electron and it will form the electronic configuration like 2, 8, 8. So it got octet configuration in the valency shell. So like this, any atom to acquire octet configuration, either it will lose one electron or it will gain one electron and share electrons. So how can it share electrons? Here one example, oxygen molecule. How it is forming oxygen molecule? Actually oxygen atomic number 8. Its electronic configuration is 2, 6. So to acquire the octet configuration, it needs two more electrons. So that's why each oxygen will share two electrons, and will get the octet configuration. Okay, so this is about the octet rule and examples. Thank you.